This last type of cell division that we'll discuss is a special type of cell division that's used only for making the cells necessary for sexual reproduction. We'll talk about meiosis in this video. For organisms to reproduce sexually, they need to make a specific type of cell known as gametes. Gametes are the sex cells, and they have half the regular number of chromosomes. And so meiosis is the form of cell division that produces gametes in diploid organisms. There are male and female gametes, both eggs and sperm, but what makes a gamete different than a regular body cell is the number of chromosomes. The chromosome number in a gamete is halved. We use the term haploid to mean cells that have half the regular number of chromosomes. When two gametes fuse together, the resulting cell, the fertilized egg, is known as a zygote. The zygote is the cell that will become the offspring. Through cell division and embryonic development, that one fertilized egg will become the offspring, or the next generation. And just like all the other cells in our body, a zygote is diploid after fertilization. In fact, it's the zygote that gives rise to all the other cells in our body. So, how does this work? What makes meiosis different from mitosis? Well, the general goal, the result of meiosis, are haploid daughter cells being produced in a diploid organism. All sexually reproducing organisms are diploid organisms, and the sex cells, the sperm and the egg, they will be haploid cells. How do we get haploid cells in a diploid organism? Well, in meiosis, two consecutive divisions occur. These are known as meiosis I and meiosis II. And even though we had two rounds of division, they're preceded by only a single round of interphase. A single round of DNA copying. In the diagrams that we'll be looking at in this and our next videos, I will tell you what the diploid number and the haploid number are for these diagrams. In this particular diagram, the diploid number is 2, whereas the haploid number is 1. Keep in mind, again, for humans, the diploid number is 46, and the haploid number is 23. So we see we're starting with a cell that is diploid. It has two chromosomes, one colored red and one colored blue. As that diploid cell goes through interphase, the chromosomes are duplicated. Now, at the end of interphase, we still have duplicated chromosomes, yet each one is considered to be a separate chromosome. So the cell is still diploid following interphase. This diploid cell then goes through the first division of meiosis, known as meiosis I. In this division of meiosis, instead of the sister chromatids separating from each other, it's the homologous chromosomes that separate from each other. So it's this pair of chromosomes, the red and the blue, that will separate. And that actually means, at the end of meiosis I, our cells are already haploid. Each cell has only one chromosome. Now those chromosomes are still duplicated at this point. The parent cell had started with two chromosomes. And at the end of meiosis I, each daughter cell has only one chromosome. It's these haploid daughter cells that then go through division II, known as meiosis II. And the end result of meiosis II, we started with a cell that had one chromosome. We end with cells that have one chromosome. And so the cells at the end of meiosis II are still haploid. Let's look at these stages again. This time with an An example in which the diploid number is 4 and the haploid number will be 2. Now, starting at interphase, this is before the chromosomes have condensed, we see the chromatin is just this diffuse mass of DNA. Yet, at interphase, the DNA is duplicated. All those chromosomes are duplicated, and we'll see those duplicated chromosomes once we start going through the first division. So in meiosis one, the chromosomes condense. Now, one thing that makes meiosis different from mitosis is that as the chromosomes condense in prophase one, this is the prophase of meiosis one, they find their matching homologous chromosome, and they form a pair. This pair is called a tetrad, or a bivalent. And so, we're starting with the diploid cell, a cell that has 4 chromosomes. The chromosomes condense, they find their matching pair, they form a tetrad, or bivalent. In metaphase 1 of meiosis, we see that it's these bivalents, or tetrads, that are lining up on the metaphase plate. So it's not the individual duplicated chromosomes, but instead the pairs of chromosomes that are lining up. In anaphase 1, it's the pairs of chromosomes that are separating from each other. Observe that the sister chromatids still remain attached, so it's not that we're separating the two halves of the X, we're just separating the two X's from each other in anaphase 1. And in telophase 1, the chromosomes decondense. Nuclear envelopes may or may not reform, but see how we'd started with a cell that had 4 chromosomes, and we've ended with cells that now only have 2 chromosomes each. These cells are haploid at the end of meiosis 1. These haploid cells are then going to go through another round of division, meiosis 2. And what we'll see is that meiosis 2 is very similar to mitosis. During prophase, chromosomes condense, nuclear envelopes break down. During metaphase, now we have the duplicated chromosomes lining up on the metaphase plate. In anaphase 2, it's the sister chromatids that are separating from each other, becoming daughter chromosomes. And then at telophase 2, new cells are formed. In meiosis 2, we had started with cells that were haploid, and we end with cells that are still haploid. So, looking at what happens in these two divisions of meiosis, in meiosis 1, homologous chromosomes pair, recombine, and separate. So as the chromosomes condense during prophase 1, the homologous chromosomes will find their matching pair. They'll find their matching part. So that's the pairing up. Recombining is when sections of these homologous chromosomes actually exchange with each other. But then the key is that during anaphase 1 of meiosis 1, that's when the pairs of chromosomes separate from each other. And really, it's the separation of those pairs that takes us from being a diploid cell to a haploid cell. When we look at meiosis 2, in meiosis 2, it's the sister chromatids that separate. This is very similar to the events that occur during mitosis. In our next video, we'll look at these different types of cell divisions and compare mitosis, meiosis 1, and meiosis 2. See you in the next video.